All right, so I have to admit that sometimes, not often, but sometimes, I experience a little bit of indecisiveness. I feel like I usually, when I go to the store and I want to buy something, I know what I want before I go, and I go to the store, I get it, and I'm done. Decisions made, purchases made, and I move on with life. But sometimes, on rare occasions, I'll have, I don't know if you want to call it buyer's remorse or regrets or second thoughts, but this is one of those cases, whatever you want to call it. I thought I might just want to go and get something else, go get the other one. And I did. And I decided that I would hang on to both of them before I decided which one I would keep. And I would compare them and do a review, and I figured I might as well bring you guys along with me so you can go through my thought process and see the differences between these two carts. So I've got two Gorilla carts here now. They're both assembled and they're ready to go, and I'm ready to show you the differences and show you how I'm deciding which one I'm gonna keep. So with that, let's get started. Now I'm gonna stay mostly in the garage for this video, but I do have some video footage that I can show you of these carts. The kids are actually out here playing with them right now, as you can see, but it's kind of windy and I don't want the wind to affect the quality of the sound of this video. So I'll start by just kind of showing you the different comparisons and things. The size, I think the size is really a big deal, especially if you're not sure kind of where you're gonna store it. We'll start there and just kind of work our way through the different features and price points and all that kind of stuff. Now I started with the 4 foot model. This is the 4 cubic foot Gorilla cart. It has small wheels. I think the wheels are about 5 or 6 inches tall or a diameter, and it can haul about 600 pounds, which is pretty cool. You can put a lot of material in there. I used it for my fountain project to hold all the rocks for me while I was working around the fountain with the bricks. If you haven't seen that video, I'll put a link in the description for you. You can check that out. And I did a really great job. It was really awesome. It worked really well. It was perfect. It's perfect for small jobs like that. As far as the dumping goes, both of these carts dump the same. They dump 90 degrees or even further than that if you need to, which is super awesome. It's a new design that Gorilla Cart recently came out with, and I think it's very, very helpful. Now, as far as actually comparing the two for size, I put my boys inside of them, and just to kind of give you an idea of what they look like. The 4 cubic foot will hold 2 small children very easily and very comfortably. As for the 7 cubic foot, you can put at least 4 small children in that thing, no problem, maybe even more. I will have to try that sometime and see how it works out, see how many kids I can fit comfortably in there, just to kind of give you a way to compare the size difference on these things. Now, of course, the bigger cart has bigger tires, which is cool because it will help support more weight, and it will help it roll a little easier when you're carrying a load. And I like that. So the big one has about 10-inch tires on it, which is super cool. Both carts have pneumatic tires, which I really like. Makes rolling them around the yard, around the property really easy. And then the biggest difference, other than the size, is the feature on the handle. The handle on the 4 foot cart is just a pull option only. You can only pull it by hand unless you want to be a little risky and kind of jimmy rig it, which is what I do with everything. I jimmy rig everything. But you can jimmy rig it if you want to tow it or hook it up to something, but it's not designed for towing. Now, the bigger cart, the 7 cubic foot cart, the handle is designed for towing. You can pull it by hand if you need to, or you can pull the pin out of the handle, slide the handle down the shaft, and then you can use the pin to hook it up to a four-wheeler or a John Deere tractor, and you can tow your load around wherever you need to go, which I think is a huge difference. Now, I have a very substantial project ahead of me in just a matter of days. I'm gonna have a bunch of sand delivered to my house to start leveling out my lawn. And I need something that is gonna be easier for me to use and that I can tow. So after going through all these features and deciding in my mind what's best option for me, I think I'm gonna stick with the bigger cart. It does cost a little bit more. I should have probably gone over that before, but the small 4 cubic foot is retailing for $99 at my local Home Depot. and the bigger one, the 7 cubic foot cart, is retailing for $169. So a little bit more money, but you get a lot more space. You get the ability to carry a lot more weight, a lot more volume, and you have the option to tow, which I think is worth all of that extra money there. So I'm thinking I'm gonna stick with the 7 foot. Make sure you're subscribed, see if I have regrets later on. I really doubt that I will, but I'm looking forward to really putting this thing to work this weekend when I get my sand delivered. It's gonna be hauling tons, literally tons of sand around my yard, and it's gonna be probably one of the biggest helps that I'll have for that project. So stay tuned for that, should be a lot of fun. I hope this comparison was helpful. I wanted to do this because I wanted other people to see the difference in size without having to go to the store. Sometimes they're not on display. I wanted to just have both of them for now. That way you didn't have to do it. You could just hopefully use this and that'll help you decide. I'll tell you one thing, these carts beat the wheelbarrow far and away out of the water. I probably won't even use a wheelbarrow for the project, but I will use these carts. And I'll enjoy doing it, and it should be a lot of fun. I know the kids enjoy doing it too. The kids aren't asking for a ride in the wheelbarrow, I'll tell you that. They're asking for a ride in the gorilla cart. So again, hope that's helpful. Thank you so much for watching. I will leave links to these carts in the description below and a link to Gorilla Cart's website so that you can get more information. Again, thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.